Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Hope you guys are well. So today in this tutorial I am going to show you how you guys can change your background with only CSS and without any JavaScript. And here you can see that we have three buttons actually in the center, and everyone is different color and our background is white. So if we now click on a button here, you can see that now our background color is changed to the button's color. And if we again change the button and click, so here you can see that our background color is again changed, and again click, and yeah, so here you can see that our background color is changing to according to the button's color, and this effect is looking so beautiful. And if you guys click outside of the button, here you can see that now our white background is coming back. So yeah, actually most of you done it with JavaScript, and as usual a lot of people actually don't know JavaScript well, so that's why I am going to show you how you can make this effect using just CSS. So before yesterday, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe my channel, like this video and press the bell icon for the future video. So let's go to our text editor. And here first you have to create your basic HTML structure, give a title and link your CSS file. So now here in body section we have to create a button, because here you can see that this is actually a button. So we have to create a button, and in this button give a class name. So let's see first one. Okay, now go to your style sheet, and here first we have to create a basic setting. So that's why margin will be 0, padding will be also 0, box sizing will be border box, and overflow will be hidden. That's it. Now save. Yeah, so here you can see that our buttons actually in the center, so I have to grab our button and bring it to the center. So that's why now copy the class of this button, paste it here. First I want to give a width and height, so that's why our width will be 55 pixel, and the height will be also same 55 pixel. And now I will give a background color, so that's why, so background color will be this one. If we now save and go to our website and here refresh, so here you can see that now we have our button. So now I want to bring this button here in the center, so that's why we have to give position. So position will be absolute, and from top it will be 50%, and from left it will be like 40%, and the transform will be translate minus 50% and minus 50%. That's it. If we now save and go to our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our button in the center. So here you can see that we have actually a outline and a border, so I don't want this outline, so that's why outline will be none. If we now save, go to our website and refresh, so here you can see that our outline is gone. So now I want to make this button round, so that's why I will give border radius, and the border radius will be 50%. So save and go to our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our button. So now I will make this button a clickable button, so that's why I will give cursor pointer. So now save and go to our website and refresh, so here you can see that now it is a clickable button. That's it. Actually here you can see that if we click a button, it's actually a box shadow, nothing else. So I will create that box shadow, so that's why I will give box shadow. And for the initialize stage I will give all the box shadow 0, so that's why 0 0 0 and 0, and the color will be this color. Now paste. That's it. So now actually here you can see that in our button, if I click on this button, here nothing is happening. So now I have to create an effect, and when we click on this button the box shadow will increase. So that's why copy this class from here and paste it here. Now I have to write focus, and we have to create a pseudo class which is focus. That's it. So now I will give box shadow, and here you can see that we have a value of 0, and I will increase this value with 1000 pixel. That's it. If we now save and go our website and refresh, now when we click on this button here, you can see that our background color is changing, but we can't see the effect of changing. So that's why I have to give a transition of 0.9 second. That's it. If we now save and go to our website and refresh here, so here you can see that now we can see our effect. So now I want a border of this button, so that's why I will give border 3 pixel. It will be 3 pixel border and solid, and the color will be white. So if we now save and go our website and refresh, so if we now click, and here you can see that now we have our border here. So now I want 2 more for different color, so that's why I will copy this button from here and paste 2 time more, and just change the class name. It will be second for the second color, and this will be third for the third color. That's it. Save, and here we just have to copy all of this, the first one. So copy this and paste it for the second button, and again paste it for the third button. So now we have to change the class also. So here you can see that this is for the first one, and this one is for second one. So that's why I will grab this second and second. So after second we have to create our third one, so that's why change this class name third. So if we now save and go our website and refresh, and here you can't see anything, because in the second one you can see that in the first one I gave left 40, and in second I also get the left 40. So that's why first one is on the top of the second one, so that's why I have to increase the left value. Let's change it 45. The first one is 40, and the second one will be 45, and the third one will be 50. So if we now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our 3 buttons, but here we have more space between the buttons, so that's why I will give it to 60, and this one will be actually 50. If we now save and refresh, so here you can see that now we have more space between the buttons. So if we now click, here you can see that our background color is changing. But now I want to change these 2 buttons color, because I want a different background color for these 2 buttons. So that's why for the second one color will be less first, and for the second one our color will be this one. So if we now save and go our website and refresh, now here you can see that now our button is a different color. I want to change this button also, so go down, and for the third one our background color will be this one. Save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have 3 different color, and yeah, this is, and here you can see that our first one, when we click, we can see other 2 button, but when we click the second button we can see the first one, and if we click on the third one we can see the first 2 one. So we have to fix this one actually, and I want these 3 buttons to on the top of the background. So that's why we have to give Z index to every class here. That's why Z index, and the value will be 1, and copy this line from here and paste it to the rest of the class. Okay, so if we now refresh, and here you can see that it is not working yet. So now we have to set another thing. In our focus class we have to give a z index also. So that's why in here that index will be minus 1000, and I will copy this and paste it to the rest of the class. So if we now save and go our website and refresh, so now here you can see that now we can see the other buttons when you click a different button. So yeah, our background is changing well. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed our tutorial, and if you guys really enjoyed our tutorial, then please subscribe, give a like to this video, and press the bell icon for the future videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.